you guys, and today's subject is EVS, also called as science, and the topic is teeth and microbes. So I've actually made a PPT, so let's just get started with it. Now let's start with the first subtopic, teeth. Teeth have different shapes and sizes. They are attached to the gums while the root holds it in place. When the root gets loose, the teeth shakes and falls down. There are many ways you can take care of your own teeth. Let's start by milk teeth. A baby is born with no teeth at all. By 7 to 8 months, the baby starts to grow teeth. These teeth are called milk teeth. By age of 3, we have 20 milk teeth in total. By the age of 6, the milk teeth start to fall and is replaced by permanent teeth. By the age of 14, all the milk teeth have fallen and replaced by permanent teeth. Permanent teeth. Let's now talk about permanent teeth. When the milk teeth start to fall, they are replaced by permanent teeth. But if this group of teeth fall, they cannot be replaced at all. By age of 14, all the teeth are permanent teeth. Now let's talk about adult teeth. Every adult has 32 teeth, 16 in the lower jaw and 16 in the upper jaw. If any of these teeth is lost, it is not replaced by another teeth. Let's learn about the types of teeth. Incisors, canines, premolars and molars. Let's start with incisors. The front teeth which cut and bite the food is called incisors. They are very flat. There are 4 incisors in each jaw. So there are 8 incisors in total. Since they bite and cut the food, they are called biting teeth or cutting teeth. Canines. Beside the 2 incisors, these teeth are used to tear the food. So these are called canines. These are very pointed and sharp like a fork. There are 2 canines in each jaw. That means there are 4 canines in total. So these actually tear the food. So for this fact, they are called tearing teeth. Now let's go to premolars. Next to the canines are premolars. They are broad and flat and they crack the food like cracking nuts. Like they crack the nuts a lot. So for this fact, they are called cracking teeth as well. So there are basically 4 premolars in each jaw, 4 in the upper jaw and 4 in the lower jaw. So there are 8 premolars in total. Let's go to the next one. The last teeth are molars. The last teeth at the very end are called molars. There are basically 6 molars in each jaw, 6 in the upper jaw and 6 in the lower jaw. So in total there are 12 molars. These actually, they grind the food into small pieces so we can digest it. These are actually very sharp from the top. And because they grind the food, they are called grinding teeth. And fun fact, the last molars are called wisdom teeth. So let's now see the parts of a tooth. The top part, which is the most sharp part, is called the crown. And even you can see over here, I'll show you even nice, more better. So you can see over here that now the crown is basically narrowing. That part of the tooth is called the neck. Like how our neck is sometimes smaller than our face. So, like us, our neck actually narrows down. So, like our faces and our real neck, the neck of a tooth is basically the same. So here you can see it's narrowing, and that's the neck. Now when it goes straight and forms two legs on each side, it is called the root. Now let's go inside a tooth. So the first layer you can see is the enamel. This is the hardest part of the teeth, and below it we have the dentite. It is hard, but not as hard as the enamel. In it, we have the pulp. It's kind of like the heart of the teeth. Now here you can see this pinkish thing, right? That is called the gum. And right below the gum, we have the bone. Now you can see this pulp actually extending to two legs, right? That is called the root canal. And now inside the root canal, we have the nerves and blood vessels. Now let's continue. Let's now find out what are the bad things what can happen if we don't brush our tooth nicely. Tooth decay can happen. Tooth decay is damage to a tooth surface or enamel. See, when it's an early decay, the decay is only till the enamel. When it's progressing, it slightly touches the dentine. When it's advanced, it touches the pulp. But when it's infected, it becomes very painful. Now, one thing that causes hole in our teeth is called plaque. Plaque is a sticky film of bacteria that constantly forms on teeth. See, when we eat any sugary stuff, anything that has sugar in it, it feeds the bacteria. What is the bacteria, you might be asking? Plaque is the bacteria. So plaque makes a type of acid that damages the tooth's surface. And over time, this process can cause a hole. Now let's find out what does it cause. It can cause toothache, foul smell from mouth, stomach disorders, hole or cavities in teeth, or even loss of teeth. Now we found out all about this stuff. What stuff can happen if we don't brush our teeth nicely or we don't take care of our teeth. Now let's find out how to prevent those things from happening. We can brush our teeth twice a day in a day, eat raw vegetables to make our gums strong, avoid eating sweets and chocolates, drink milk all the time, and floss our teeth daily. Flossing is basically you are removing all the small pieces of food in between your teeth. Sometimes the lettuce or anything you eat, vegetables, it gets stuck in between. So if you floss it, it will get removed, so it doesn't look dirty. And you also have to brush your teeth in the correct way. You have to brush your teeth twice a day and also brush it in the correct way. And also you have to visit the dentist twice a year, once in every 6 months. Now we've learned all about teeth. Now let's go to the second subtopic. Microbes. What are microbes? Microbes are small living organisms that can cause diseases. And microbes also have different types. And these tiny organisms can only be seen through a microscope. Now let's find out the types of microbes. We have virus, fungi, bacteria, protozoa, and these are just the main. But there are even more. But these are the main microbes. Now let's find out all the harmful things microbes can do to us. A virus can cause polio, smallpox, influenza, etc. Bacteria can cause typhoid, tuberculosis, and even more. Protozoa can cause malaria, dysentery, and sadly even more. Fungi can cause ringworm, athlete's foot, even more stuff. Now you might be wondering, after all these microbes have done so many bad stuff to us, then how can it be very useful? Now you must be wrong. See, a microbe might sound harmful when we talk about its harmful things, but if we talk about its good stuff it can do, you'll be shocked, because microbes can help in the most unexpected ways. So let's find out about these unexpected ways, shall we? Okay, one lactobacillus, or one bacteria, can turn milk to curd. Yeast helps to bake cakes, bread, etc. And yeast is one type of fungi. See, some kids obviously like cakes a lot, right? So without a microbe, we don't even have any cakes. And also, one bacteria helps in decay of plants and animals. Thank you guys, the presentation is over. I hope you like this video. Make sure to like, share and subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you in my next video. Till then, goodbye.